there's a big gap between what climate scientists know and take for granted and see happening and see unfolding in the data and what policymakers are thinking about when it comes to multi-year risk of drought. Really trying to integrate information that we have in the climate science community about climate change and its impact on drought risks with what we know about what's possible because it's already happened. This project would try to bring together practitioners, not just from WTW, but other dimensions in both the private and public sectors with the climate scientists who are really well-versed in the data and the methods, but maybe don't fully appreciate how valuable their knowledge can be for some of these sectors. In many cases, we've discovered already that like we have some of the answers in papers we've published that we don't even think are going to be relevant to what they're asking. One can infer that the effects of drought are pretty far-reaching. They impact the energy sector. They can impact insurance pricing for real estate, for infrastructure, for a renewable energy grid that's going to hopefully be more integrated with solar and wind when now people are switching on their ACs, or they're installing heat pumps, or you have people going to the hospital because they're overheating, and now there's a new set of energy demands that have emerged from this second or third order effect of drought. And those are the questions that we get asked, and we haven't honestly thought about them until this project started. There are two big picture things that I think we've come to so far. Number one, this background change in the temperature is not going away, and it's affecting the statistics and the likelihood of drought risks. Number two, it's really valuable to have people who know something about science and know something about who the stakeholders, who the end users of those scientific products are. Because when you have those two types of expertise in the room together, you're able to generate ideas for best practices that go beyond what any large language model can do without that informed expertise from people.